Hello everyone, my name is Alisha Rai and today in this video I'll be discussing with you all what constitutes arrest and what is the difference between custody and arrest, and I will also be discussing about what are the reasons that arrest is made. So let's proceed. Arrest, as we all know, that in general terms it is happened when any person who do or have done something in a position of the law, then the person is arrested. The Code of Criminal Procedure has not defined that what arrest is. Like the word arrest, it ordinarily means the apprehension or the restraint or the deprivation of one's personal liberty, and the arrest means a physical restraint put on a person as a result of the allegation of the accusation that he has committed a crime or an offense of quasi-criminal nature. And arrest means seizure or the forceful restraint and exercise of power to deprive a person of his liberty, or taking or keeping of a person by any lawful authority into a custody, and especially in response to a criminal charge. So arrest is completed as soon as the suspect is no longer free to walk away from the arresting police officer, thus depriving that arrested person of his or her freedom of movement as well. Here also, after arrest, a person's liberty is under the control of the arrester. The person is taken into custody and his will by the physical application of force or submission to an officer arresting him or her. But it is to note that every deprivation of the personal liberty physical restraint is not arrest, that is, cannot be considered as arrest. Only certain cases, like if there is deprivation of the liberty by a legal authority or at least apparent legal authority, or any under the color of the office and in a adept manner, only leads to arrest. However, a person against whom no accusation of crime has been made may be arrested or detained under the statute for many reasons, like removal in safe custody from one place to another. For example, removal of a minor girl from a brothel. So holistically, if we try to understand that what arrest is, then arrest is a procedure that is connected with the criminal offenses only, that is consisting of the taking into custody from the lawful authority in order to hold or detain the accused person. The arrested person, and to answer a criminal charge, and to prevent the commission of the crime, or to prevent that person from absconding. So since an arrest, it deprives the person of an freedom, of his freedom, so it must be exercised with utmost care and caution. In cases where the accused person, they were arrested not by the police, but they surrender before the magistrate. So such taking into custody of such persons by the magistrate will also come under the ambit of arrest. And in one of the cases, like in Roshan Bibi versus Joint Secretary of Government of Tamil Nadu, it was said by the court that the essential elements required to institute arrest are that there must be intent to arrest under the authority, accompanied by the seizure or detention of the person in a manner known to the law, which is so understood by the person arrested. And this was said in this case. So I hope it is clear that what arrest is and what constitutes arrest. Now, I will be moving towards what is the difference between custody and arrest. So, let me tell you first that both these terms, they're not synonymous. Custody and arrest, both are different. While if we see that what arrest is, then arrest is not defined either in Code of Criminal Procedure or any other substantive acts. When the police charges someone with a crime and then takes them into custody, it is arrest, provided the police have sufficient evidence, credible information or reasonable cause that the illegal act committed by is committed by that person. the criminal law, it also expresses custody as a second stage of arrest. And taking a person into the judicial custody is followed after the arrest of the person by the magistrate on appearance or the or surrender. Like as per section 27 of the Indian Evidence Act, the expression in custody denotes the surveillance or restriction on the movements of the person connected. Custody is a legal right or duty to take care, is also a state of being guarded or kept in prison temporarily, especially by the police. So in every arrest there is custody, but not vice versa. Thus, mere taking into custody of a person or an authority, then who is empowered to arrest may not necessarily amount to arrest. So this is all about what arrest is and what custody is. And I hope the difference is clear. Now, what is the reason behind arrest? So if we see that why arrest is made and where arrest is made, then arrest is made in both cases, like criminal cases and civil cases both. But it is very, the situations become very drastic, then only arrest is made in the civil cases. While in the criminal cases, it can be made for many reasons, like to find the probable cause of the offense, to prosecute or interrogate the accused, to notify the society that the individual has committed a crime, and to deter him from committing any crime in future. And it is also done to secure the attendance of the accused at the trial on the charge of some crime, and where his attendance at the trial is necessary, and to secure the administration of law, or say the adjudication of justice. So it is arrest is also made as a kind of precautionary and preventive measure where there is imminent danger of the commission of the serious offense, that is the cognizable one. And arrest is also made for obtaining the correct name and the address. It is also made for removing the obstruction to the police to carry out the duty. And lastly, this arrest is also made for retaking a person escaped from the custody. So in all these cases, arrest could be made, and it is totally lawful on the part of the lawful authority to make any kind of arrest of the persons. Now, talking about the arrest of the persons under the CIPC, we know that section 41 to section 60 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, it deals with the arrest of the persons. A person may be arrested with warrant or without warrant, and such arresting authority could be like anyone. It could be by way of court, it could be by individual person, and it could be by the police. So all these persons are the could be arresting authority. Now, to conclude all these things, I would like to say that it is not a denying the fact that arrest, it brings a demoralizing and diminishing effect in one's personality, and the person so arrested becomes outrageous, alienated and hostile. Thus, every attempt and the caution should be made on the part of the arresting authority that there exists a balance between the security of the state and the individual freedom. And only then the real objective would be satisfied and be achieved. So that's all for today. Thank you for listening.